Tomorrow marks the one-month countdown to Epi's Great Race. And in today's Workout Wednesday, we're focusing on the third leg of the triathlon. Personal trainer Suzanne Cardenas is back from California Family Fitness now to show us some tips to get through the kayaking portion. I love this is my favorite part.
This is your favorite part?
I love it because you've had a hot day and then you get into the water.
Well, yep.
Sometimes literally.
Yes.
And it's just refreshing.
It is refreshing and it's kind of a fun little twist to it. So you want to get there early. That beach is going to be covered with hundreds of boats and so it's hard to find your boat. So you want to make sure you get there, get your bib number on it, and get some streamers or something really wacky or crazy so it's easy to find it from the beach.
I used an Elmo balloon one year.
That
long before I had children, and it was ideal.
It was ideal, yeah. You really do want to get there and get set up early. If you're doing the whole event, you want to put some water, some food, and some sunblock in there as well. So Erin is demonstrating, so it takes a little bit of balance, which you're going to need in a kayak and on the water, and then she's just doing a row. So she's connecting the movement with her legs, which actually, in kayaking, especially when you're in kayaks, you actually steer your boat with your legs, not necessarily the paddle. So you want to think about
that's a good thing to not discover the day of the race, too.
It is. So, if this is your first event and you've never done a kayaking section, you go and stop there and come down on the floor, you want to maybe take some classes, you know, to get comfortable. Oftentimes, or sometimes, kayakers end up in the water. So, you know, the lake looks, you know, the river looks really big, but when you're down there and there's hundreds of boats next to you, it gets a lot smaller. So you don't want to end up in the rapids. You want to kind of know the course. So get out on the lake, get out and practice this stuff. But if you haven't kayaked before, take some lessons.
And you're paddling more than 6 miles, which is why having the good core strength and the back workout a month ahead of time is great because you will tire.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, you've already run. You've already biked. It's getting warmer, and so you're getting tired, and so you want to have a nice, strong core. That's going to help you for all three events, but really for the kayak. And you want to have a nice, fluid movement, keep the upper relaxed. And then I'm going to ask Erin to come onto the boat. So say you're like, oh, I do all those all the time, Suzanne. How can I make it more fun?
Take it up a notch.
This is one of my favorite exercises. Now, it's not easy, so she's going to get herself set. So she's on an unstable surface, and then she's working her core from there. So it is a very fun, challenging, and it burns from the first rep all the way through.
She's doing a good job, too. She
is
strong because that is a lot harder than you would think.
Yeah.
I love that you said get on the water because it does narrow very quickly, particularly when you get to the San Juan Rapids.
Yeah. And so, again, if you haven't, go out on the course. The water levels are great this year, so you have time to get out there, get out on the lake, or whatever you need to do to get comfortable with your boat. Again, if you're renting, go take those classes. Just get comfortable in the water so you know what to expect and how it's going to feel race
day. All right. Sounds good. Thank you very much to both of you. And don't forget, we always post these segments, these Workout Wednesday segments at kcra.com/morningnews. So you can see this segment and other segments that Suzanne has joined us with, along with California Family Fitness. And you can still register for Epi's Great Race. It's coming up Saturday, July 21st. We're back with more right after this.